I'm always impressed with and grateful for when I watch is it goes beyond the step. The step is just what the medium they're moving through to tell the story, to get to render an emotion or something from the audience. And it was clear that you had wonderful dancers and you were moving them through rigorous paces, but at the same time, you were trying to get them to work with this feeling as opposed to in the mire of it. Just to bring out the regalness of
being and letting what the body do what the body does, and that is the expression.
Deep inward thoughts and well up all this emotion. I don't think Vicky Baltimore was all the guys are surrounded, she's in the floor in second position, her legs open, screaming, second position, and little Mamela Rare walked up and went, shh, and she stopped. And I'd never seen anything like that, such a blend of dance and theater. And then in The Man Called Jesus, when you were bringing in the fabric, and you moved it back, and you bought it, it seemed like they disappeared from nowhere. Those things, it was just
fun then.
That's the way you did it. It was so theatrical. And but it was great dance, told a great story. Very focused and...
Yes. Yeah, we tried it, yeah.
And then people always talk about, you know, nowadays, simplicity is a bad word, because everything has to be busy. It's 500 steps and everything. When the art form itself, it was... Simplicity really is maybe the hardest thing you can do.
Absolutely, I think so. Because you have to strip away all the excess, you know, that you have. Right now, I don't know if the kids are in, well, I'm sure they're concentrating, but I wouldn't blame it on them. I hate the fact that they always say, oh, the dances are great and the choreography is terrible and so forth. Why blame the choreographers all the time? It's like, it's a collaboration. Anytime you're going to give a dancer a step, it's a collaboration. And how you both can convey that message, if it is a message that you're conveying, or executing something that could be very, very mechanical, and then you have to adjust even to that. But I don't think that there's a distinction between that. This is 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't know if they know really when you have graduated from the classroom and you have gone on to the stage. The stage takes something else. It takes a larger dimension. The stage period, I don't care what you're doing, what style, but it takes a larger amount of concentration and whatever the fruit of that collaboration is going to be. I mean, you can take your time and do the rehearsals, but if you don't rehearse the details of what the motives, so you know sometimes, you know, as to why you're moving, I think that it can be, because like an actor, it can be indulgences. So, you know, or you have to attain the stature of an actor.
Some people
yourself to that, because you're elevating the art. You're not trying to diminish it. Then to be able to convey that without words. So it's because that's what a dancer does. It's without words that you're saying, even no matter what your accompaniment is going to be. And sometimes even with the words, how well you can define the meaning of the words, like what is the juxtaposition of what they're saying and what we're seeing.
But that's one of the things I say about this. I say, you're the only person I know who's 70 going on 17, you know? You really do that for me. I mean it in the most sincere and respectful way. You still have that childlike quality.
I think you lose it. If you come back, you got to jump on that train and keep moving. Because the other, what is the other? The alternative is something else. But anyway, no, because there's so much fun to be had. Do you know what I mean? Because, you know, like you think as you get older, kids are running away. Kids are having a hard ass time just living. It's, who could live? Who can live? This is ridiculous. Just an apartment, Now, don't talk about crust of bread and such.
Yes, or trying to live on your own.
Or having any fun.
Yeah.
Or not always in crisis mode. You know, how can you relax and create and breathe and all of that if you're going to be off, working from crisis. And a lot of us are working from crisis all the time and enjoying that's, you know, the fruits of life. I mean, is to be able to enjoy, share, and live.
And work on Saturday. The name of the piece is going to be, do you have a name for this?
Yeah, the Kingdom Come.
And you're still, how many performances do you ultimately see the project as?
Oh, we could have, we could have 12, 15, ultimately. But it's just as pure with 8, 10, 12, well, I'm back to 16 again. So I always love to have that like that. But I think it's just inspiration, to be so grateful for the life that I've had and, the things that I've been able to make, in collaboration with all these other people we look to. Do something with Gina Ellis out there in Detroit in doing the Wiz of the Wiz. And then, showing where that inspiration, what that inspiration spawned. And it spawned a lot of other performers, famous performers, regular people that find a deeper being inside themselves and are able to transform themselves and move on to something, some higher inspiration.
Well, right, this summer when you did the Wiz outdoors, I came to try to do every performance, and the one thing that I noticed, the audience remembered the music. They looked forward to things like the tornado dance. They looked forward to certain pieces of choreography. They looked forward to seeing Glenda come in. These were things that you could feel the anticipation in the audience. And when they started singing the songs, they sung them like they were lullabies. They sung them right along. They hadn't forgotten anything.
Right. For the years. And the music and lyrics of Charles Smalls for that show are stellar. And the song, having been made famous by wonderful artists and so forth. But often, our heart was in it. And I think that really makes a difference. So it's, when it is, the audience knows it. They pick up on that. So it's like, it's great. So we're all getting off. We're having a good time. And we're having good times on Broadway right now. It's an enormous amount of creativity going on right now. And I think we are the beneficiaries of it, but we've got to get back to ourselves, and sharing those diverse gifts.
Thank you for taking the time out to talk to us.
Oh,